Hello everybody, my name is Faethodas, welcome to this video. This is the challenge rift number 28. This is the first challenge rift for the new year to 2018. Also, happy new year to everybody. This is a Crusader build. It is not such a good build. It makes sense with the items that it has, but the items are not very good. But anyway, let's check out the build and then we will go. I will make my first attempt to complete the rift. And if you are new players, I will tell you how to play if you want to complete the rift. So, this build is using this set, the Seeker of the Light, the complete set. This set gives some advantages, some boosts to Falling Sword skill and Blessed Hammer skills. And it is using the helm with a diamond gem in the socket for a reduced cooldown of all skills, which is very important for this build, the cooldown reduction. It is using the shoulders, the gloves. As we can see, the items are not the best. The chest armor, the pads, and the boots. It is also using the belt of the trove, legendary belt. It is also an ancient, but it doesn't really matter. With this one, every 7 seconds, call down bombardment on a random nearby enemy. Okay. For the amulet, it is using the Zephyrian amulet. It is a good amulet, but it is not the best. But anyway, what can you do? This is the build now. It also has the Bane of the Powerful legendary gem in the socket. Only rank 25, nothing more. Here we have the Gabriel's Vambresis. When your Blessed Hammer hits 3 or fewer enemies, 56% of its wrath cost is refunded. This is very nice, because it helps with the wrath the generation. For the rings, this build is using the Obsidian Ring of the Zodiac with the legendary gem Gogok of Swiftness for more attack speed, more dodge chance, and also for better cooldown reduction with this legendary gem. And the Obsidian Ring of the Zodiac, of course, helps to reduce the cooldowns of the skills when we use the Blessed Hammer skill, because this is a cost a resource cost a skill. Here we have the Eternal Union. Another ring with the Bane of the Stricken, legendary gem in the socket. It is not the best ring out there, the stats are not very good, but anyway, what can you do? Also, the legendary power of this ring is useless for this build, because there is no phalanx skill in this build, so it is useless. Now, for the weapon and the shield, we have the Guard of Johanna, or Joanna, I don't even know. This one has the legendary power, Blessed Hammer damage is increased by 208% for the first 3 enemies it hits. This is very good when the Blessed Hammer skill hits elites as the first 3 enemies. And here we get the Yesis Hammer of Vigilance. This one is not a good item, the stats are not very good. It has the green emerald gem in the socket though, and increase the size of your Blessed Hammers. This is the legendary power of this item. As we can see, the items are not the best, but they work. They can do the job for a tier 50 greater rift, because this one is a tier 50. For the Canaris Cube powers, this build is using the Faithful Memory. Each enemy hit by a Falling Sword increases the damage of Blessed Hammer by 80% for 10 seconds, max 10 stacks. So this one helps with boosting the damage of Blessed Hammer. The Hammer Jammers, enemies take increased damage from Blessed Hammer if we blind them. And we blind them with this build, so it is very useful. And the Roger Shoe Stone increases your life per second by up to 100% based on your missing life. Now for the skills. This build is using the Shield Glare skill with the Zealous Glare, the Falling Sword with the Flurry, the Blessed Hammer Limitless, Provoke and Cleanse, Loss of Valor, critical. Akarat's champion, prophet. And the passive skills of the build are Holy Cause, Blood, Finery, and Fervor. Or Fervor. Anyway. So, this is the build. These are the skills, these are the items. Now, if you are new to this game or to the Crusader class and you don't know how to play it and you want to try it, get the reward, and you are not interested about the leaderboards, here are the leaderboards, here is the tier of the rift, 50. Here is what we need to do inside this rift. What we need to do is to always try to cast the skill Falling Sword. And especially when there are many enemies in one place, for example, say there is 10 or 20 or at least 5 enemies here in this area, we cast it here, because of this one, it increases the damage of our blessed hammers because of the items that we are using and the skills. And after we do that, also this one is helping because of the bonuses of the set. It reduces the damage that we take, so this is important to be using it very, very often. To increase the damage of Blessed Hammer, and also to reduce the damage that we take. It is very important also to have this one active, Akarat's champion, because it also increases the damage of our build, and also it increases the defense of our build, and this build is fragile if we do not have activated these two things here, these two skills, we will have big problems. So, at least this one we can activate it very often, but this one not very much. So, at least this one we have to remember to always activate it. And especially against when there are many enemies in one place, then we activate it on them. Now, also, as we said, we have to have active this skill too for more defensive damage. And when we are against some enemies, and especially elites, we need to use the Shield Glare on them, because with this one we will blind these enemies, and these enemies, when they are blinded, they receive 400% more damage because of the Blessed Hammers item, this one here, when we use, of course, Blessed Hammers on them. And of course, we have to always remember that when this one is available, we activate it so we can attack even faster. And because we attack with the Blessed Hammers only, and this one, also the faster and the more frequently we attack, the better cooldowns we get for all of our skills, and especially this one, because it has a very long cooldown period. So, one more time, we activate all the time the Falling Sword. We have active, when we can, the Akarat's champion, especially when we fight against the Lich or many enemies. We use the Shield Glare upon enemies, and especially elites, for them to be receiving more damage by Blessed Hammers. We use the Loss of Valor because we got even more attacking speed. And of course, this is the Blessed Hammer skill. Now, for this skill here, the Provoke, this one taunts enemies to attack their attacks, to target, to focus their attacks on our hero. And this one helps with gaining more wrath, so we use this one only if our wrath is down, if it is empty here. But this will not really happen. Not that often, at least, so we don't give too much attention to this Provoke skill. Let's go and try to do it. Boom! Okay, these guys are dead. Against small guys like this, we can use the Todd skill. And it will bring them closer to us, so they will receive more hits by the Blessed Hammer. So it is a good idea to use it sometimes, this skill too. It is not completely useless. Come on, come on, come on! This rift is not that good, at least the first 2-3 levels. Had enough? No, we haven't enough. Here we get the power pylon, we kill these elites here. We take these balls and we run backwards, because we will meet one more elite pack in this area. Here it is. And now we go down to the third floor. We have to be careful against these bulls, because they can kill us with one hit actually. Oh, I'm going to die. Or maybe not. Oh, I died. And here we have the conduit pylon. Come on here. Okay. One more elite pack. Let's try it, be careful. Come on, elite. Where are you going? Stay close to me, I love you. Let's move faster a little bit. And now we go down to floor number 4. We will meet some challenges here, because this floor is full with Rager enemies. I almost died here. This is not an easy rift to play actually. If you are a new player, you will die many times, and you probably will need to play the rift many times before you will be able to complete it successfully. But with a little patience, everything can be done in this world. Elite pack! Yes! Bring him on! 37 seconds! Can I do it? No, I don't think so. Especially if he runs like this. Yes, I can do it! Yes, I can do it! Yes, I did it! Okay, that was it. I made it successfully. Completed time 5 minutes 32 seconds. Original runner's time 5 minutes 54 seconds. I'm not even inside the leaderboards. This was not a good performance, but at least my goal has been succeeded. I successfully completed this rift, and the reward is mine. As we can see, this is a kind of a hard rift to play with if you are a new player, especially. So remember that you have to be using all the time this thing here to boost the damage of your blessed hammers, and also to boost your toughness, and also to help with reducing the cooldowns. You have to be using this one whenever you can. You have to be using this one against many enemies or elites to blind them, gain back some wrath, and also boost the damage of your blessed hammer against them. You have to be using all the time the loss of valor to increase your speed, attacking speed, and critical hit damage. And also, this is also useful sometimes when there are many enemies scattered around, and they are not that strong enemies, small enemies. You can use it on them. They will gather around you, and your blessed hammers will easier hit these enemies and kill them faster. So it is a build, not that good build, with not that good items. The stats of the items are not very good. This is a hard rift. The rift is not very good. You are going to have big problems. This year starts with a problematic challenge, actually with a challenging rift for new players at least. But anyway, if you try it, and if you insist, you will be able to make it. So thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions, leave a comment below, and I will reply as fast as I can. So have fun and good luck.